Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students. So now we are going to start with a very wonderful concept, or I would say the most difficult concept of partial differentiation. Now why I'm saying it is difficult, because student feels this concept difficult, but from my point of view it's very easy, because the reference of this concept is present in the 12th standard. So we are going to learn the concept. The name of that concept is implicit function. So here we are going to see how to find out the derivative or the partial differentiation if the given function is implicit. So now to start this concept, I will take one function. So let's say if I have function of x and y, and let's say if it is equal to 0, or if I have function of x, y and z and it is equal to 0. And let's say if somebody is asking me to find out the value of dy by dx, then how to get that value? So guys, these type of questions we have done in 12th standard. So let's take an example. So that you'll remember this concept. So in 12th standard, we have seen that, let's say if we have a function like y square plus xy equal to 0. And let's say if somebody is asking us to find out the value of dy by dx, what we do? We differentiate each term with respect to x. So here, if I differentiate y square with respect to x, we will get 2y into dy by dx plus, here we have to apply UV rule. So this will give us x into dy by dx plus y into derivative of x is 1. So this is equal to 0. Now to get the value of dy by dx, we'll take all terms of dy by dx together, and this y will go on the right hand side because it does not have dy by dx. So that will become negative y. And if I take these two terms together, then in bracket I'll get 2y plus x into dy by dx. And if I send that 2y plus x on the RHS, it will go in the denominator, we'll get 2y plus x. So guys, this is the value of dy by dx. So this is how we used to do the differentiation of a function if it is given in this form. Now the thing is, let's understand the concept of implicit function. What is basically the implicit function? So I'll explain you this concept with the help of tree diagram. So here, as it is said that f is a function of x, y and z. So I'm just considering f, so I'm assuming that left hand side is f. So let's say here I'll write f equal to this. So f is a function of x, y and z. Now what is implicit function is, when we have the given function with multiple variables and one of the variable is a function of other two variables. So let's assume that z is also a function of x and y. Or in this case, if I assume this as capital F, then here I would say, let's say f is a function of x and y, and let's say y is again function of x. So what is happening? The f is function of x and y, and again that y is a function of other variable. So such type of function is called as implicit function. So guys, how to identify that this question belongs to implicit function? So there are two ways to identify. The first way is, whenever a function is given, the right hand side is equal to 0 or it is some constant. So let's say here if I have 3, what we'll do is we'll take that 3 on the left hand side, it will become negative 3, and we can bring right hand side as 0. So right hand side is 0, one thing. And the second thing is, if you observe the question, so in the question they will ask you like this, either dz by dx or dz by dy, kind of a thing. Now if you think logically, then f is a function of x, y, z, then they would have asked you df by dx or df by dy or df by dz, as we have seen in the normal any function where we find the derivative. So in that, what happens, there is one dependent variable, there is one independent variable, and we get this term where here we get the dependent variable and we differentiate that, or we differentiate that given variable with respect to some independent variable. So what we assume is that we should get df by dx, df by dy or df by dz. But in question, you will get dz by dx. Now, what you have to observe is, in that question, they will give you one function of x, y and z. And if they are asking dz by dx, then it clearly denotes that z is dependent on x. Because if z is dependent on x, then only you will get the value of dz by dx, or else you will not get the value. You will get 0. Next, if z is a function of y, then only you will get the value of dz by dy, else you will get the derivative of z with respect to y as 0. It means z has to be a function of x and y. So this is how we have to identify. Let's say if instead of this they are asking you find dy by dz, so you have to be sure that y is a function of z. So this is how you have to identify if it is implicit function or not. So there are two ways to solve. So one way I have shown you that we have to differentiate each term, okay, and while differentiating you have to keep in mind the term which is asked. So let's say if this question is coming, that is dz by dx, so what I'll do is I will differentiate each and every term with respect to x, but whenever z comes, that time I will not treat z as a constant, but I'll treat that z as a function of x and y. So I will differentiate that z with respect to x, and after that we'll take all terms of dz by dx together and remaining terms on the right hand side, and we'll get the answer. So the same method which I've explained you, by which you can get the answer. So this is one method. The second method is, here we can derive a formula for implicit function with the help of partial differentiation. So I'll show you that method also. So now I'm gonna derive a formula for this implicit function, where f is a function of x and y and y is a function of x. Now guys, if f is equal to 0, then we all know that df is also equal to 0. So let's say if I want to find out, now here you can see that f is a dependent variable and this x is an independent variable. So if I want to find out the value of df by dx, so how to find it out? So the thing is, we'll apply the chain rule. So the first path is from f to x, and then from f to y, y to x. So for this path, if I find out if I apply the chain rule, then by partial differential I'll get del f by del x. So why I'm taking this as a partial differentiation? Because if I differentiate f with respect to x, I can treat y as a constant. Next, if I apply the chain rule on this path, here I'll get plus del f by del y into del y by del x. And guys, this is equal to 0. Now why 0? Because it is given that f is 0. So if function of x and y is 0, its derivative is also 0. Now let's move ahead. So can we call this? So guys, here this is capital F, because we have assumed that function as f. So can we call this as fx? So this suffix x denotes that we are differentiating f with respect to x. Next, and that too partially. This, the value of dy by dx. Now guys, here we have written del f by del y. I'll explain you once again, because when I'll differentiate f with respect to y, we can treat x as constant. But when I'll differentiate y with respect to x, there is no other variable present. That is why we will get a complete differentiation. So here we should write dy by dx. So again, del f by del y, we can call it as fy. And here we have dy by dx, which is equal to 0. Now, if I want to find out, I'll say dy by dx is equal to, so this f of x will go on the right hand side, will become negative f of x, and this will go in the denominator, so that will become f of y. So guys, this is the formula to find out the value of dy by dx. So here, what we have considered, y as a function of x. Now there might be another condition where we'll say f is a function of x and y, and x is a function of y. That is possible. So in that case, we'll get a question. Let's say if I want to find out df by dy, how we'll find it out? So here I'll write down for you. So df by dy is given by, so again I'll apply the chain rule. For first path, we'll get del f by del y, plus for second path we'll get del f by del x into dx by dy equal to 0, because f is 0. So therefore here we'll get fy, here we'll get fx, And here we have dx by dy equal to 0. It means, guys, if I find dx by dy, here f of y will go on the right hand side, that will be negative f of y upon f of x. So here we got two formula, one is for dy by dx, one is for dx by dy. So guys, this is the standard formula, direct formula, which you can apply to get the answer of dy by dx or dx by dy whenever given function is implicit. And remember one more thing, that this f of x, fx and fy are the partial differentiations of f with respect to x and y respectively. So if I want to find out, let's say, the answer of this question, okay, so how I'll do that? By using the formula method. So you can remember these two formulae with one hint, that whenever you want to find out dy by dx, you can observe that in the numerator we have x term, in the denominator we have y term. So I can say that this x goes in numerator and this y is coming in denominator. Similarly, if I'm finding dx by dy, y is going in numerator and x is coming in denominator. So you have to remember that the numerator, if we are finding dy by dx, whatever is the variable in the numerator will come in the denominator, and the variable in the denominator will go in the numerator. So this is how we'll find dy by dx and dx by dy. And also one more thing, we have a negative sign with that. So guys, now we have two choices. Whenever we get a question, we can either solve it by differentiation with term by term, or we may use the direct formula. So here, to understand it very well, what I'll do is I'll take one simple example for you. So we have already seen the example of y square plus xy when I started this video. So there we got the value of dy by dx, here I'll write as negative y upon 2y plus x. So this was the answer. Now this answer we got by differentiating each term with respect to x. Now I'll find out the value of dy by dx by using this formula method. So according to formula, dy by dx is negative fx fy, where f is that function of x and y. So I'll assume this as capital F. Now I will differentiate this with respect to x and with respect to y to get the value of fx and fy. So fx and fy equal to, so guys, I told you already that this is partial differentiation of f with respect to x. So let's start. So if I'm partial differentiating this f with respect to x, y will be treated as constant. This is 0. Here I'll get answer as y. Similarly, if I differentiate with respect to y, here I'll get 2y plus here I'll get x. Now guys, let's use the formula. So the formula is dy by dx is equal to, now how I'm remembering it, the sign is negative, x will go in the numerator, so here we'll get fx, y will come in the denominator, it is fy. Now let's put the value, this is negative, value of f of x, or fx, not f of x, y upon 2y plus x. So guys, you can observe that you are getting the same answer. So here, this method you had used in the 12th standard, and this is what the method that we have just learned. So guys, what I feel is if you use the formula, then you can get answer in like minimum steps, or let's say if your function is more complex, then instead of differentiating each and every term, if you use this partial differentiation, then getting the answer is an easier task. Now same thing is applicable for the function, which is a function of x, y and z, and let's say again a z is a function of x and y. So in that, guys, whenever we find out the value of, let's say, dz by dx here, or let's say if we find out the value of dz by dy, then this x goes in numerator, as I told you. So here we will get fx and here we'll get fz, because z will come in the denominator and we'll get a negative sign. Similarly, here we'll get negative fy and here fz. So guys, these are the formula we will use if the given function is implicit and it's a function of x, y and z, and one variable is the function of other two variables. So I think I've explained you all the things which are required to understand the implicit function. Now in the next video, we are gonna learn few numericals which are based on implicit function. So guys, keep watching the videos and don't forget to share this video with your friends, because they can also understand this, the concept of implicit function, very well, and they can also attempt the questions based on implicit function in the exam. So don't forget to subscribe and press on the bell icon, because then only you will get updates about my all lectures. Thank you very much.